It's March 25, 2024. I'm at the World Health Organization with Roshan, and we're here for a negotiation on a pandemic treaty. And Roshan, could you introduce yourself and tell people a little bit about yourself before we start?
Sure. Thanks, Jamie, for the interview. I am Roshan Joseph. I am a lawyer working with Doctors Without Borders, Medicines of Frontiers. MSF is a medical humanitarian organization working on providing medical care to people in distress. And I'm here in Geneva following the pandemic treaty negotiations at the WHO, which is believed to be in its final stages of negotiation. And we are here to push to have a future where medical care or medical products are available to everyone, everywhere during pandemics and health emergencies.
And you're a lawyer?
Yes, I'm a lawyer.
And how do you think things are going so far?
Compared to last week, I think reading from the room, that's what I can tell. Reading from the room, it's much better. I think things are progressing. The negotiator seems to be making progress on the article, from article by article. But what I hear from here is it's not final yet. They are still discussing. So I think it's progressing since last week. From the first 2 days, I saw that the room was a bit gloomy, but over the week we saw that there has been people have been discussing things with each other, so there clearly seems to be a trust developing, and hopefully that we can see a agreement coming this week.
Now, is this the first time you've been involved in a negotiation like this?
At the international level, of course, this is the first time that I'm coming here at the WHO, but I have been following the free trade agreement negotiations in the region earlier. So, this is the first time that I've been coming to the World Health Organization.
When you come to a place like this and you're credentialed as an NGO, can you explain to people, how you do your work? How do you engage the process working for an NGO?
Right. So my primary role is to with MSF working is to analyze the text that is being coming out and analyze the treaty or analyze the draft provisions that's been published by the World Health Organization, and give analytic inputs to MSF, and also based on that analysis we push for changes that support public health and support people's interest. So currently in the text we would like to see a people-centered approach being taken. We need that treaty that is being negotiations, the people's health is being kept at the center of the whole negotiations, considering that it's being negotiated at the World Health Organization. It is only just that people's health is being kept at the center, and that would mean that there is access and availability of medicines, vaccines, and diagnostics during pandemics and health emergencies.
Has anything really surprised you this week?
I wouldn't say there are surprises, but as I mentioned earlier, that it is good to see that the negotiators and the member states are mingling more further. As I said, in the earlier 2 days, last Monday and Tuesday, things were gloomy a bit, and there were clearly some tensions being seen. But that's been improved over the course. I'm happy to see that it's been improved over the time.
Before I turn off the video, is there anything you'd like to add?
Yes, of course. The treaty negotiations are going for almost 2 years now, and we've always heard that the member states and WHO wants to keep equity at the center of the negotiations. But just saying equity is not enough. We want to have concrete mechanisms. We need to have concrete solutions incorporated in the text to ensure that people have access to the text. People have access to medical products. Furthermore, the treaty negotiations is not about, it should not be about pharmaceutical bottom lines, but it should be about saving people's lives. So it would be good that if we keep that at the center of the negotiation, keeping that in mind that people's lives are important, I'm pretty much sure that this treaty would be a game changer. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.